All right, so now we're going to practice breaking the wheel. Coach Jansen has a good half guard. He's got his foot right here, and I'm trying to put pressure into him, and it's not really working. When I do this move, it's really important. Say, if I was in Coach Jansen's position, it's really important that my foot is on my belly, because if it's not, I'm going to just like start going through. But if I'm here, there's not much I can do. He can leg press me off, and that's really bad. So I want to change the game. Get your grips. So if Coach Jason is right here, I want to get my hands to this position. Now I'm controlling the inside space. I'm going to control his leg, and I'm going to come up and turn this direction. And then from here, what Coach Jason went over. So he's here, I'm trying to attack him, this hand comes underneath, now I'm controlling the inside. I can control the collar. If my opponent doesn't have a collar, then I'm going to control the inside of the hip bone. And if he's not wearing pants, for whatever reason, I'm going to control the inside, post, step, and then kick back. Knee on the belly. Oh, there. Controlling. I'm trying to get this. I can't. I create a little bit of space. Get inside. Come up. Turn. Kick. And knee on the belly. Does anybody have any questions?
So, his foot should be on the outside or on the inside?
It doesn't really matter. What you want is the soles of the feet connected. So, if I'm on bottom, I know if I know the bottom of my feet are connected, I'm winning, and he really can't touch me. And if I'm on top, I know if Coach Jason gets this position, I'm in danger of being swept a bunch of different directions or just kicked right off. But if he's here and put pressure, I go there. Now I'm a little bit safe because his feet aren't touching me anymore. That's what we're gonna do next. Right now we're just going to eat one. You know, it doesn't take any kind of sensitivity. I'm just going to move here, step.
So there's not a good way of placing that foot?
You want it to be on center mass. So like, for example, you don't want it to be on the arm, because like the arm can like move. You can have it on the leg, but the hip is, your opponent can't really do much about his hip. It stays. The head can move, the arm can move, the legs can even move, but the hip, the center mass, it always stays. So that's a good place to enter. Any other questions? All right, let's go. Ready? 1, 2, 3.